Hey guys, welcome to another episode of What the Heck is Steve Talking About? It's Instructional Assistant Steve coming at you today with a lesson for Mary Romero's 432 hydraulics class. And we're going to be working out of our Amitrol program. It's actually Amitrol Module 4, and it's on hydraulic speed control. So let's get started. Okay guys, so what we're gonna go over today, as I mentioned, is a meter in flow control circuit. And really how we're gonna do that, and again, it's gonna be on this circuit here that I'll post, but you also have access to in your Amitrol. The key to it is the flow control valve right here in the middle. And I've drawn a kind of a crude diagram for you to look at, but I wanna explain it to you before I take you over to the trainer and show you how this works. The red line dash lines are possible paths for the hydraulic fluid to flow, right? So on our valve, what this means is this. When we pump this direction, the fluid's gonna come down here and hit this check valve, and it really is just what it shows you. It literally could be a ball that hits into an orifice and clogs the orifice, and the fluid can't get through, right? So we're controlling the fluid in that matter. But what the fluid can do is go through this direction. Now this, through this orifice here, this arrow indicates, and in our case, it's adjustable. I'll show you in a minute, there's gonna be a screw on the top we can adjust to increase or decrease the fluid. So as fluid goes this way, it's very much going to be metered. We're going to meter it into the cylinder, right? Because it's going to come this direction. Well, when we reverse the directional control valve and the fluid reverses direction, what's going to happen is there's going to be, sure, there's going to be some flow through this metered part, and that's fine, but there's definitely going to be flow this way, because again, you've got an orifice that's clogged up that way. Well, when the fluid comes from this side, it's gonna push that ball open, which is spring loaded in there, right? And the fluid is gonna flow free out of the cylinder. So that's how we meter in to the cylinder, but we're not necessarily metering out, because the fluid can take two different paths depending on what direction it's flowing. So let me get this thing plumbed up over here, and we're gonna take a look exactly how a circuit like this works, okay? Okay guys, so I'm gonna just give you a quick tour of what I've got here. I know it's a lot of hydraulic hoses for you to try and make sense of, but it does in fact follow the diagram that I've posted on the video, and it's skill number 4, module number 4 in Amitrol. Page S04-1. And really what we're doing is we've got fluid pumping into our DCV, right? Then it's going through our flow meter, so we can indicate flow. We know we've got fluid flowing. And then we've got, what we've got here are three pressure gauges. Now, the important part is this. Pressure gauge A here is plumbed in before our flow control valve. Pressure gauge B is plumbed in after our flow control valve. So what that means is, back to my crude little drawing, it's going to show us pump pressure on one side, and the gauge B is gonna show us the pressure that we're actually allowing to reach to the cylinder on the other side. And here, in fact, is the flow control valve. This is what I have drawn on the whiteboard, right? It's a pretty simple valve. Yep, there's a check valve in there, there's a ball in there, and you can even see the diagram here on our trainer is very similar to what I drew up on the board. It's very simple, but it's very effective. So the fluid's gonna come in, it's going to be metered by however we set this, and then it's going to come back out. Now, when the fluid flows the other way, when it goes this way, it's going to have free rein to go through that check valve and back to the tank. So here's what happens. The lab tells us to tighten that down and then open it by a half a turn, which is going to be pretty restrictive on the flow. But let's see what happens. Let's fire this thing up. Okay. So we've got our gauges and our flow meter hooked up, right? We're good to go. Now I'm going to operate the directional control valve here, and let's see what happens. And there's our cylinder moving really, really slow because we've only opened that flow control valve by a half a turn. So we are literally restricting that flow. But now I'm going to reverse the DCV and retract the cylinder, and let's see what happens. Well, there you go. It goes at full speed because the fluid bypasses and goes through that check valve that I drew on the board and goes freely back to the tank, right? So let's do it again, but we're going to watch the gauges. Remember, gauge A is showing us pressure before our flow control. Gauge B is showing us the pressure after our flow control valve. So let's see what happens. And we've got lots of pressure on A, but not a whole lot on B, right? Because we're restricting it with our valve. Right? That's pretty good stuff right there. So I've extended it. Let's retract it. There we go. It goes at full speed. I'm going to do it one more time. So we are, in fact, metering in the fluid to our cylinder. Here we go. And what we're not doing is we're not metering out the fluid. So let me reverse this and we can see how fast it goes. So there you go, guys. It's a pretty simple concept. Okay, guys, I think we have the meter in concept figured out and shown pretty well here. If you have any questions, as always, my email address will be below. Certainly, you could start by reaching out to Instructor Mary Romero. But either way, we'll get your questions answered. And yeah, that's it. I think that wraps this one up. That's a short one. So thanks for watching. Ah, you thought I was going to cut away to some heavy metal guitar riff or something, huh? Well, I am, but it's going to be in a minute. So you got to bear with me here. There's one other concept that I need to show, and it doesn't, I don't think it warrants a second video. The two concepts go together. So I'm just going to tack it on here to this video. And so yeah, that should work out just fine. So let me flip my camera around here, and I'm going to explain the second concept to you. So what I'm getting at is this. On my original drawing here, and the original circuit that I plumbed up and showed you operating, we were controlling we were metering the inflow to the cylinder, right? So when we were pumping fluid into our hydraulic cylinder and extending that rod, the fluid was going through this metered portion, right? That little screw cap that I showed you where we could adjust. And when the fluid was coming out of the cylinder, it was going out through that one-way check valve, and it was really not metered. It was free flowing. Well, this next concept I'm going to show you is similar, and it's going to be really quick, but it's what we call meter out. So in fact, these two connections are going to be reversed, right? So the fluid that goes into the cylinder is going to be able to free flow through the cylinder. But the fluid that's coming out of the cylinder is going to be metered. It's going to go through our metered portion right there. So I've already plumbed it up. And this is actually skill 5, page S05-1, skill 5. And I've already, like I said, I've already plumbed it up. And so it's really the same concept, except we're not restricting the fluid that goes into the cylinder. We're restricting the fluid that goes out of the cylinder. Okay, so let's give that a crack. So again, we've got our flow control valve here. We're going to open that up just a half a turn like that. And So what's going to happen is any fluid that gets pumped into the cylinder, well, it could free flow if it wants to. The fluid that comes out, not so much, because we're going to meter it, right? So there we go. We're going to meter that. And then when we reverse it, it goes back to full speed. And that's all. So again, the only difference between these two concepts is one is called meter in. We're metering the fluid that goes into the cylinder. The second concept that I just showed you, we call that meter out. In that case, we're only metering the outflow of the fluid. Okay, guys, I think that finally does it for me on this video. Once again, thanks for watching. My email's below if you need to get a hold of me, and you know how to get a hold of your instructor, Mary Romero. And we've got some more videos coming at you for this 432 class. So keep your eyes open, and if you would please subscribe to my channel so that you will be notified as they pop up. And of course, Mary Romero is going to be notifying you in Canvas also when they get posted. So all right, here we go. Thanks for watching.